Sir, in the last videos, we covered about inheritance, next encapsulation. These two modules we covered very clearly, right? Sir, now the next cinema, what we have to start? Polymorphism concept. Sir, under polymorphism, we have to discuss overloading, overriding, these kind of things we have to discuss in detail, right? But before talking about overloading and overriding, one very important concept we have to discuss, because that concept I'm always keep on using in overloading and overriding. What is that concept is? Method signature. Are you getting? Sir, you people should have clear clarity about method signature. Method signature. What is the signature of a method? Okay, like, can you please tell, if I'm taking a Java method, public void, m1 method I'm taking, int i, or let me take int return type, instead of void return type, int return type I'm taking, public int m1 of int I float f, okay, this is about my method. Can you please tell, what is the signature of this method? Yes, friends, which is called method signature? What is the signature of this method? Very important, because in overloading, method signatures must be different. In overriding, method signatures must be same. Like, several times we are going to use the word method signature. That's why you people should have clear clarity. What is the method signature? Can you please tell, sir, for this method, which is called method signature? Yes, friends. Okay, please make sure method signature consists of method name. Method name. Sir, what is the method name? M1. Method name. What is the method name? M1. Next, followed by argument types. Are you getting? Sir, int, comma, float. Okay, that's all. This is called method signature. Method signature contains method name followed by argument types. Remember this one, sir. So here just only types. Here int I am not considering, because it's a variable. It can be any variable name, can be anything, but type int. Second one, sir, float. Even this order is also important. First we took what? Int. Next we took what? Float. That's why method signature contains method name followed by argument types. Clear for all of, right? Sir, who is going to use method signature? Next, what about return type? Return type, sir. Int return type is there. Please make sure, in other languages like C++, return type is part of method signature, but not in Java, sir. In Java, return type is not part of method signature. Remember, method signature contains only method name followed by argument types. Okay, well, clear for all of that, which is called method signature? Okay, well. Now, who is going to use method signature? Sir, very simple. Compiler will use this method signature while resolving method calls. Are you getting who is going to use, right? Compiler will use method signature while resolving method calls. Sir, what it means? I will explain a small chota example, then you people can get much clarity here. Just observe that. I'm taking a simple class test. Assume that class test I'm taking, sir. Now, here, public void m1, like this I have, public void m1 of int I, sir. Public void m1 of int I. Sir, public void m1, okay? m2, let me take m2 of string s. M2 of string s, like this I have. Now, just, sir, this is about, how many methods are there inside test class? Two methods are there, sir. Now, sir, just, I'm creating an object, test t is equal to new test. I want to call these two methods, right? Sir, you know, whenever we are making a call, t dot m1 of 10, t dot m2 of Durga, something like, I'm just calling these methods, right? Sir, whenever we are performing method calls, compiler should aware, compiler should check whether these methods are available inside test class or not. You are getting? How the compiler will check, sir? So while resolving method calls, compiler is always going to use method signature. Remember this one. Sir, now for this class, for every class, compiler will maintain one table which is called method table. Remember this one. For every class, compiler will maintain one table. What is that table, sir? Method table for that class, it is going to maintain method table for test class, right? Sir, how many methods are there? Two methods, sir. What is the signature of first method? M1 of int. What is the signature of second method? M2 of string. Regarding M2 of string. Sir, method signature contains only method name followed by argument type, sir. Now, sir, observe that P dot M1 of 10. How the compiler can decide? Sir, is it a valid method call or not? Very simple, sir. You are calling M1 and T. T is what type, sir? Test type. Observe, this type of orientation must be required next. You are calling M1 method on T. T is what type? Test type. Are you getting? Now, which argument you are passing? Int type. So, inside the test class, is there any method which can take int type as the argument or not? Yes, there is a method which can take int type as the argument. Are you getting? Inside the test class, is there any method which can take int type as the argument? Yes, there is a method. Is there? Compiler feels that yes, it is the legal. Are you getting? Similarly, so T dot M2 of Durga, you are calling M2 method on T. T is what type? Test type. Bypassing which one is the argument? String is the argument. Is there any M2 method inside test class with the string argument? Yes, man. With this method signature, there is a method is there with this signature. That's why happily it is going to call. Clear, right? Sir, now take very special care. Now I'm calling T dot M3 of 10.5. Immediately, compiler will check, array, you are calling M3 method, and T bypassing double A the argument, 10.5, floating point lateral by default, double type, right? So now you are calling M3, you are calling double A the argument, M3 method and T. T is what type? Test type. Now in the test class, is there any M3 method with double A the argument or not? No such type of method. With the required signature, there is no method. Immediately, compiler is going to object, boss, no such type of method. Are you getting? No such type of method. Like this, immediately, compiler method by default you are going to get. Are you getting right? So, what is a method signature? Who is going to use these method signatures? Compiler will use these method signatures while resolving method calls. Clear, right? Sir, let me execute what exact compiler method you are going to get. I will show here. Observe that carefully, sir. Here, observe that. Sir, here forget about all this stuff. I don't want to worry. Sir, here inside class test, I'm taking one method, public void M1 method of int I as the argument. This is the first method, sir. Public void M2 method which can take string as the argument. String, yes, like this I'm taking, sir. Sir, that's all. This is about M1 and M2 two methods are there. Now, sir, I'm trying to take test T is equal to new test. Test T is equal to new test. T dot M1 of 10. Can you please tell, is it valid or not? Yes, friends. Is it valid or not? Yes, because you are calling M1 and T. T is what type? Test type. Sir, M1 with int as the argument. Is there any method with the signature or not? Yes, that's why perfectly itself is valid. Clear for all of it, okay? Sir, let me execute this code. Here, observe that. Let me compile Java C test dot Java. Perfectly valid. We are not facing any problem at all, right? Similarly, T dot M2 method bypassing Durga as the argument. regarding T dot M2 method, bypassing Durga as the argument. Yes, this one is also perfectly valid, sir. No problem at all, because with the required method signatures, already sir methods are available. That's why no problem at all. But now, observe carefully, sir. T dot M3 method bypassing 10.5 as the argument. Are getting immediately compatible method by default you are going to get. Can you please observe what is that compatible method, sir? What is that compatible method? Cannot find the symbol. Which symbol, sir? Method M3 of double. Have you observed, right? What is this, M3 of double? Boss, there is no such type of method. There is no such type of method with this signature. Have you observed, right? Method name followed by argument type, sir. With this signature, my compiler unable to find any method. That's why immediately compile method we are going to get. Clear for all of you, right? Sir, now observe very carefully about this one. What is the method signature? And who is going to use method signature? Method signature contains method name followed by argument types. Who is going to use method signature? Compiler will use method signature while resolving method calls. Clear, friends? Up to this? Sir, there is one very important point is there related to method signature. What is that point is? Just observe that carefully, sir. Sir, I'm taking class test. I'm taking class test, public void M1, public void M1 of int I. Like this, I have one method is there, sir. Next, public int M1, public int M1 of int J is there. And here, return type is a int, that's why it is expecting some int value. Can I get a return 10? It is expecting some int value, right? That's all. This is the method what we have. Now my question is, take very special care about this terminology, right? Can you please tell, if I'm taking, let me create an object. Assume that I'm creating an object. Test t is equal to new test. Test t is equal to new test. T dot M1 bypassing 10 as the argument. Sir, I'm calling M1 method bypassing 10 as the argument. Can you please confirm which method is going to get in the chance? Friends, please respond. Which method is going to get in the chance? Either first method or second method? Are you getting? Either first method or second method? Sir, if you are taking like this, immediately compatible method we are going to get. If we are taking like this, immediately compatible method we are going to get. What is the reason for that? The reason is, do you know, within the same class, two methods with the same signature is not allowed. Sir, because whenever you are calling like this, which method has to respond? Because this method matched. Even this method also matched. Regarding this method, what is the signature of this method? What is the signature of this method? M1 of int, sir. What is the signature of this method? M1 of int. M1 of int. That's all. Now, two methods with the same signature. Two methods with the same signature itself is there. Are you getting? Two methods with the same signature itself is nothing but not at all acceptable. Because if any person is calling M1 bypassing int value, which M1 method has to respond? It is always a problem. That's why. So within the class, two methods with the same signature is not allowed, sir. Whether we are calling or not calling, immediately compatible method we are going to get saying M1 of int is already defined in test class. Pass is already defined. Why you are redefining again another method with the same signature? Like that compatible method we are going to get. Clear for all of right? So the important conclusion here is, within a class, two methods with the same signature not allowed. By mistake, if you are trying to take compatible method, we will get, even though return types are different. Are you getting? One is void, but the second one is int. Even return types are different, but make sure, okay, within the same class, 2 meters with the same signature not allowed. Sir, let me check this one. Sir, which compartment we are going to get, I will show. Have a look once. I'm taking class test, public void M1 of int I. Okay, like public void M1, oh, public int M1 of int K. Can you please tell what is the signature of first method? Please respond. What is the signature of first method, sir? M1. What is the signature? M1 of int. Are getting M1 of int. What is the signature of second method? Yes, second method signature is also M1 of int. So both methods having the same signature. That's why immediately compartment method you are going to get. Clear for all of you, right? Sir, let me cross check. Observe carefully, right? Now let me compile. Let me compile. What is that compartment method, sir? Method M1 of int is already defined in test. Why you are redefining again? Why you are redefining again? What is this M1 of int, sir? This is called method signature. Regarding with this signature, already a method you defined. Why you are redefining again? This is the compartment method by default you are going to get. I hope everyone can able to understand, right? So these are the important loopholes you people should aware. What is method signature? Next, who is going to use method signature? Next, within the same class, if two methods having the same signature, what will happen? Immediately compartment method we are going to get. Clear for you? Okay, that's all. Hi friends, in the last video we covered what is method signature, who is going to use method signature, and important point related to method signature. Okay, well, sir, now the next concept, major concept, very important for the interview room, very important for day-to-day coding, overloading. What is the concept, sir? What is the concept? Overloading we require to discuss in detail, right? Can you please observe, when we say that two methods are said to be overloaded. Sir, these two methods are called overloaded. When we say these two methods are said to be overloaded, sir, very simple. Have you observed, right? Here I have M1 method is there. M1 method is there. Sir, what is the argument? Is argument type? Argument is M1 of int. I have another method is there. What is the argument type? Long. Long. Can you please observe these two things? Sir, method names are same. Method names are same. But argument types are different. Method names are same. But argument types are different. Different. So, when we say that two methods are said to be overloaded, if and only if both methods having same name but different argument types. Okay, remember this one. Same name but different argument types. Okay, what about return type? What about modifier? What about throws keyword? All that nonsense we are not required to worry. Of course, in detail we will discuss. So just at very top level, you people should be aware, when we say that two methods are said to be overloaded, if both methods having same name but different argument types. Okay, well, so now, do you know in C language, C language is a method of overloading concept is available or not available? Not available, because C language is not object oriented. C language is not object oriented. That's why in C language overloading concept is not available. Okay, like that's why two methods with the same name under different argument types. So no such type of option. Are you getting? If you consider ABS method is there, sir. This ABS method is always applicable, sir, for int type. In C language, there is one method is there named with ABS. ABS method is there. It is always applicable for int type. Sir, I want to find for long value, absolute value. For long type, I want. So, if the argument are changing, if the argument is changing, compulsory method name must be changed. Because two methods with the same name, different argument types is not allowed in C language. Not allowed in C because overloading concept is not there. If there is a change in the argument type, compulsory we should go for new method. That's why what is the for long type, sir, which is the absolute method we require to use? LABS. Are you getting? Similarly, if the argument is float type, if the argument is float type, the method name is FABS. Are you getting? So how many ABS methods are there? For ABS, default for int type. For long data type, LABS. For float data type, FABS. Like that, multiple ABS methods are available because two methods with the same name but different argument types are not allowed. Then how many method names we have to remember? Yes, obviously for every type separate method name we have to remember. Complexity by default is going to be increased. Programming complexity is going to be increased, right? Remember. But in Java, are getting? But in Java, we are not having any such type of complexity, sir. Because in Java, you can take same ABS for int type, same ABS method for long type, same ABS method for float type also. Because in Java, we can take same name, multiple methods with the same name, with the different argument types is allowed, which is nothing but method of overloading. Regarding this concept is nothing but what? Method overloading. Okay? Sir, having method of overloading concept in Java reduces complexity. Because for every type, we are not required to remember separate method. Single method name we can use for any type of argument. Such a type of more flexibility you people can expect in Java, right? Are you able to understand? So really, having overloading concept, is it advantage feature in Java or not? Yes, but in C language, do you know, if there is a change in the argument type, compulsory we should go for new method, unnecessary complexity of programming is going to be increases. Clear? Now, up to this, you people should aware only 2 points, right? When we say that two methods are said to be overloaded, both methods having same name but different argument types is called the overloaded methods. Next, what is the biggest advantage of overloading? More flexibility to the programmer. We can use the same method name, even argument types are different, no problem at all. Complexity of programming is going to be reduced. Clear, right? Sir, I hope it's very clear for you what is when we say that two methods are said to be overloaded. Let me go for a small program so that you people can get much clarity. Observe that carefully, sir. I'm taking a class test. Have a look once, class test. And here public void m1 method I'm taking, sir. Observe. Method name and argument types. Very important. More concentration must be required. Sir, here system.out.println no arg method. Regarding SOPR, no arg method. Similarly, public void m1 of int I. Public void m1 of int I. System.out.println int arg method. Are you getting? Int arg method, right? Sir, now public void m1 method, public void m1 method of double d system.out.println double arg method. Are you getting? Double arg method, like this, right? Can you please confirm how many methods are available? Sir, m1 without any argument. M1 with the int type of the argument. M1 with the double type of the argument. Are you getting? Total how many methods are there? 3 methods are there. Have you observed for all the 3 method name is the same. M1. But the argument types are different. Here no argument. Here int argument. Here double argument. Can I use the word? All these things are by default considered as overloaded methods or not? Please confirm, all these methods are by default considered as overloaded methods or not? Yes, obviously, these methods are said to be overloaded methods. Okay, well, sir, now the important conclusion. Okay, what the meaning of overloaded well? How the method resolution by default will be there, sir? Now, let me write the main method in this class. Public static void main string array args. Observe very carefully, sir. Continuation, main method I'm writing. Now, tester t is equal to new tester. Tester t is equal to new tester. Sir, now onwards, orientation you require to habitize a new orientation, right? T is what type? Tester type. Reference type is a tester type. Runtime object is a tester type. Of course, here I'm using only one class. Sometimes reference type may be different, runtime object type may be different. But as of now, here same reference object type is also same. Whenever we are calling t dot m1, you are calling m1 without any argument on t. T is what type, sir? Tester type. T is what type? Tester type. That's why immediately tester class m1 method, no argument method, is going to execute. So what is the output by default we are going to get, sir? No arg method. Okay, well, now t dot m1 bypassing 10. T dot m1 bypassing 10. Sir, do you know you are calling m1 on t? T is what type? T is what type? Test type. In the tester class, M1 method, which can take int type as the argument, this method is going to get in the chance. That's why int arg method will get the chance. Observe that. Similarly, do you know t dot m1, if I can take 10.5, is by default what type? Double type. Now, do you know M1 method, which can take double as the argument? Now the corresponding method will get the chance. Observe that, a bit very carefully. Sir, based on argument type, based on reference, automatically the corresponding method by default will be executed. So, I hope, is the clear for all of you, right? Sir, let me execute up to this, and then I will go for very important conclusion, sir. Observe carefully. Here I have a look once. I have no arg method is available. Sir, first method, no arg method. Int arg method. And then what the last one? Double arg method. Like three methods are there, sir. Now the point is, inside main method, let me create an object. Tester t. Is equal to new test I'm taking, sir. Test is equal to new test t.m1. Are you getting t.m1? Sir, have you observed? I'm calling no argument method. Then obviously which method is going to get in the chance, right? No arg method will get the chance. Observe that. Happily the code compiles fine. Now, if I run this code, which method we will get the chance, sir? No arg method is getting the chance. Okay, well. Now, t.m1 of 10, sir. t.m1 of 10. 10 means int value. 10 means int value, right? Now, which method is going to get in the chance, right? Int arg method by default will get the chance, right? Sir, which method is going to get in the chance? Int arg method will get the chance. Similarly, t.m1 of 10.5. Sir, obviously, double argument method will get the chance. The code compiles fine. What is that answer we are going to get? Double arg method we are going to get in the chance. So, please make sure you people should be aware how to declare overloaded methods. Next, how you can call overloaded methods. It is a very clear, right? But from this example, one very important point we have to conclude, sir. In overloading, observe, T is what type? Please respond. Sir, you are calling M1 on T. T is what type? Test type. Runtime object is what type? Test type. In overloading, method resolution means which method has to execute. That process is called method resolution, sir. In overloading, method resolution always takes care by compiler. Are getting who is the responsible, sir? In overloading method resolution is always takes care by compiler based on reference type. Remember this one. But anyway, here reference type, runtime object type is the same. That's why you may not get much clarity from this example. But while next examples going on, somewhere definitely you people are going to get much clarity about this one, sir. But please make sure you people should aware, sir, in overloading method resolution always takes care by compiler based on reference type, but not based on runtime object. Sir, it's always going to take care by compiler based on reference type. That's why overloading is also known as compile time polymorphism. Are you getting what is this one, sir? Overloading is also known as compile time polymorphism. Compile time polymorphism or static polymorphism. Static polymorphism or early binding. These are various other words for overloading. Are you getting? In overloading, method resolution is always takes care by compiler based on reference type. Are you getting? Compiler based on reference type. That's why. So overloading is also known as compile time polymorphism or static polymorphism or early binding. Remember this one. Here, runtime object is the dummy and JVM is not responsible for method resolution. Compiler is responsible. But from this example, you are not going to get much clarity. But while examples going on, you people can get much clarity up to this. Are you able to get right? About this point, I will explain in detail in the next coming example. Somewhere you will get much clarity. Believe me, sir. That sir, in the last video we covered very clearly about what is overloading. Next, in overloading, who is the responsible to perform method resolution? Can you spell out who is the responsible to perform method resolution? Compiler is responsible to perform method resolution based on reference type. Hence, overloading is also known as compile time polymorphism or static polymorphism or early binding. Clear, right? Sir, now there are multiple cases are there related to overloading. Let me talk one by one, right? Sir, the first case, observe carefully, sir. Here I have class test, public void m1 of int I, int argument method. Public void m1 of float f and the float arg method. Regarding this is the int arg method, this is the float arg method. Now, can I use the word, these two methods are overloaded or not? Can you please spell out? These two methods are overloaded methods or not? Yes, obviously these are overloaded methods, right? Now, main method, public static void main, tester t is equal to new tester, t dot, observe very carefully, sir, t dot m1 bypassing 10 as the argument. 10 means which type? Int type. By default, every integral literal is of what type? Int type. That's why int arg method will get the chance. Okay, well, int arg method will get the chance. T dot m1 of 10.5f means float type. Float type means float arg method will get the chance. Are you getting? Float arg method will get the chance. We know up to this, already we covered in the last example, same. Sir, let me execute up to this. Now the next I will explain. First up to this, let me execute, sir. Here, sir, the same public void m1, int arg method, public void m1 of float f, float arg method, t dot m1 of 10. Then obviously, which method we are going to get, sir? Int arg method will get the chance. Observe that, int arg method, right? Now, t dot m1 of 10.5f, t dot m1 of 10.5f. Are you getting which method will get the chance, sir? Now observe that float arg method will get the chance. Clear for all of you, right? Sir, that's it. Now, the next point you people should be aware, sir. Sir, it is the very, very important. Observe carefully. If I can take theta m1 of A, sir. Array, A is what type? A within single quote. A is what type? Char type. Can you please tell T dot M1 of A char type? Which method will get the chance now? Which method will get the chance now? Can you please confirm? Which method is going to get in the chance? Either int method will get the chance, or float method will get the chance, or we will get compile time error saying no such type of method, because your int is there, float is there, but you are passing char as the argument. Can you please confirm? Very, very important concept. That is our first case. Which method is going to get in the chance? Okay, very simple. In overloading, so while performing overloaded method resolution, if exact matched argument method is not available, sir, you are passing char, but there is no method with char argument, right? Compiler immediately won't try is compile time error. Regarding compiler won't try is immediately error, sir. What the compiler will do? First, the compiler will promote this char type to next type. Are getting? First compiler will promote this char type to next type. You know, automatic promotion somewhere. What is the promotion? Automatic promotion chart, byte. Byte can be promoted to short. Short can be promoted to int. Int can be promoted to long. Long can be promoted to float. Float can be promoted to double. In our basics, somewhere we covered in the first unit, sir. Char can be promoted to int. Sir, please make sure you have to inject this chart in your mind. So, in overloading, if exact matched method is not available, compiler won't raise compile time error immediately. First compiler promotes this argument to next level. Sir, char can be promoted to int type. Okay. After promoting to next level, it will check, is there any method which can take int type as the argument. Regarding it will check, is there any method which can take int type as the argument? It will check, sir. If there is any method which can take int type as the argument, yes, compiler will give the chance for that method. Assume, sir, now what is the answer we are going to get, sir? Int argument. So this is called automatic promotion in overloading. Remember that, sir, in overloading method resolution, if exact matched method is not available, compiler won't raise compile time error immediately. First it will promote argument to next level and will check, is there any matched method is available or not. If it is available, it will get the chance. If it is not available, again promote into the next level. Sir, all possible promotions completed, still no matched method, then only we will get compile time error. This is called automatic promotion in overloading. Are you able to understand that case one? What is the meaning of automatic promotion in overloading? Like, sir, according to our scenario, for the care, which method will get the chance now? Respond, man. Which method is going to get in the chance? Yes, sir, care. No exact match. Care can be promoted in time. That's why int arg method will get the chance. Are you getting? Int arg method, right. Now, have a look once. Same method I'm taking, sir. Same method, t dot m1 of A, sir. Are you getting? T dot m1 of A. Sir, exact matched method is not there. So, char can be promoted to int type. Char can be promoted to int type, sir. Now, int argument method is already available. That's why int arg method will get the chance, sir. Now, observe last output, sir. Now, have a look once. We are not going to get any compile time error. Happily, the code runs fine. But in that output, sir, int arg method is going to get in the chance, sir. This type of concept is called automatic promotion in overloading. Clear? Now, my next target, sir. T dot M1 of 10L I'm taking. Are you getting? 10L. What is 10L? Respond. What is the 10L? Then L is nothing but what? Long type, long. Is there any method which can take a long argument? No, we have only two methods. One is index, second one is the float. That's why according to our chart, long can be promoted to float. Are you getting? Long can be promoted to float. Sir, after promoting, do you have any method with the float argument or not? Yes, that's why obviously which method is going to get in the chance, right? Float arg method will get the chance. Clear, right? Okay. If I can pass long value as a long argument method is not available, then obviously which method is going to get in the chance? Float arg method by default will get the chance. Clear, right? Now let me cross check. Have a look once. Now T dot M1 of 10 L, either small L or capital L, no problem at all. T dot M1 of 10 L, L. Sir, long type exact matcher method is not available. Long can be promoted to float. That's why float argument method will get the chance, right? Okay. Well, last output, can you please observe that? What is the last output we are going to get, sir? Float arg method, very clear. Now, I have next doubt, sir. What is my next point is, if I can take T dot M1 of 10.5. Sir, very important. T dot M1 of 10.5. Can you please confirm? 10.5 by default what type? Hey, respond. 10.5 by default what type? Double type. Sir, now the argument what you are passing, double. Is there any method with a double type? No. No method with a double type. Okay, well. Now, is it possible to promote a double to the next level? Sorry, not possible because double is the topmost. Next level promotion is not there. So, promotion not possible. Exact matched method not available. Immediately, compiler will give left and right. Array, where is the method? Like in this case only, we are going to get compile time error. Are you getting right? First compiler will do a good thing for you. It will try to promote and check, is there any matched method? Sir, all possible promotions completed, still matched method is not available, or promotion is not possible, then only you are going to get compile time error. Is it clear, right? Let me cross check this case. T dot, can you please tell? T dot M1, 10.5. Can you please tell? 10.5 is what type, sir? Double type. Is there any method with the double add argument? No method. Is it possible to promote to the double type? No. Double to next level? No promotion. Then immediately compiler will give left and right, method resolution fails. Are you getting? Now observe that no suitable method found for M1 of double. Are you getting right? No suitable method found for M1 of double. First it will try M1 of int is not applicable. Okay, M1 of int is not applicable. Next it will try M1 of float is not applicable. Sir, it checked both but still not applicable. That's why we are going to get compile time error. Are you able to understand? This concept is called automatic promotion in overloading. Very important concepts are even next level constructors concept, there also it is applicable. So in overloading method resolution, if exact matched method not available, we won't get compile time error. First this argument will be promoted to next level. Okay, sir, after promoting, either matched method is available or not available, next level promotion again, sir, like all possible promotions completed, still matched method not available, then only we are going to get compile time error. This concept is called, what is this concept? Respond, man. What is this concept? Automatic promotion in overloading. Clear, right? Sir, in the last case, we covered automatic promotion in overloading. Now, the next possible question, even the next case, let me talk. Here, class test, public void M1 of objective O, SOP of object version. Next, public void M1 of string S, SOP of string version. public static void main like this, right? Can you please tell what is the argument to the first method, M1 of object O? What is the argument to the second method, M1 of string S? Both methods same name but different argument types. So can I use the word overloaded methods or not? Yes, these two methods are said to be overloaded. Okay, well, now main method tester T is equal to new tester. Sir, T dot M1 of, sir, new object I'm taking. Are you getting? New object, T dot M1 of new object I'm taking, sir. Now the point is, listen, a bit very carefully, sir. If I can take new object, so which method will get the chance, sir? Sir, object argument, string argument, then object argument will get the chance, sir. Very, very important point. In overloading, while overloading method deletion, exact match will get highest priority. Remember, that's why which method will get the chance, right? Object version will get the chance. Okay, well, no problem at all. Now T dot M1 of Durga I'm taking, sir. If I can take Durga, T dot M1 of Durga is what type? String type. Then obviously object version, string version, exact match will get highest priority. That's why which method will get the chance, right? String version will get the chance. Regarding which method will get the chance, string version will get the string version, right? Up to this, let me check, and then the next point I will explain. Observe carefully, sir. Here I'm taking two methods, right? Here I'm taking two methods. First method, M1 of object version, M1 of string, yes. Okay. T dot M1 of new object. I'm creating an object and I'm passing that object as the argument. Right. Now which one is always going to get in the chances, sir? Exact match will get the highest priority. That's why object version will get the chance. Now have a look once. The code compiles fine. What is the output we are going to get, sir? Object version like this, right? Now, sir, T dot M1 of Durga I'm taking. T dot M1 of Durga, like this I'm taking, sir. Now, which one is going to get in the chance? Yes, obviously, string version will get the chance. Regarding which version will get the chance? String version will get the chance, right? Sir, up to this, it's a very clear for you. Now, the cinema is going to start. Observe carefully, right? If I can take T dot M1 of null, like this, right? Null value, I'm passing null value. Can you please confirm which one we will get the chance? First one, object. Second one, string. Null is a valid value for any type of object reference. Null is a valid for string reference also. Can you please tell who is going to get in the chance now? Getting? Both methods got matched. Because null you can provide in the place of object, in the place of string. Which method will get the chance? Very easy. You can able to guess. Which class is the parent class? Which class is the child class? Observe that. The parent class is object. Child class is string, sir. Object and then string. String is the child class, object is the parent class. Can you please tell, in overloading, parent and child both came, which one is going to get the chance? Very simple, sir. Very simple. Suppose here in the government office, collector is there, attender is there. Suppose I have a small work is there saying, array, I will go to collector office. I want my required signs. Observe that signatures are required from the collector. Then obviously I should meet the collector. Okay, suppose at what time collector is available or otherwise. So I want some general information. If attender can help then I can complete that work only with attender. I'm not required to go for collector level or getting collecting the superior person, man. Okay, directly for small, small problems also. So we should not go to the superior. First we will check with the child level. If the child level is not going to work, then only we should require to go for parent level. You know the rule. Obviously, you can able to guess which one is going to get in the chance. Can you please respond? Who is going to get in the chance round? Null, null referent. Null applicable for string, null applicable for object. So in parent and child arguments are there, always child will get the chance. If a child class can't, if child not matched, then only parent level we will go. Are you getting right? Sir, now p dot m1 of null, which one is always going to get in the chance, right? String version will get the chance. So in overloading, parent argument, child argument, which argument will get highest priority, sir? Child argument will get highest priority when compared with the parent argument. Okay, now let me check t dot m1 of null value. Null value. It is matched for both. Observe, have here, which one is going to get in the chance, right? Yes, the output by default we are going to get last one, string version, right? Remember that string version will get the chance. Suppose, assume, child method is not available. Child method is not there, sir. Then obviously, parent is going to get in the chance. If child method is not there, automatically who is going to get in the chance? Parent will get the chance. Let me show this one. Sir, here, I'm trying to remove child method. Next, the remaining method calls also. Only one method call, t dot m1 of null. Regarding child method is not there, that's why who is going to get in the chance, right? Obviously, parent is always going to get in the chance. Regarding, but the answer we are going to get, simple object version. Sir, this is case 2 of overloading. From this, what we learn, sir? In overloading, exact match will always get highest priority. Next, if parent and child both methods got matched, both argument methods got matched, always priority will goes to child. If the child argument not matched, then only parent argument is going to take care. Child class argument will get more priority than parent class argument. Clear? Sir, now the next case related to overloading, observe carefully, sir. Class test, public void m1 of string s. First method, string argument method, string s. Public void m1 of string buffer sp. Are you getting what is this one, sir? String buffer. Now, public static void main string array args. Test t is equal to new test. I'm taking... Sir, here, can I use the word, these two methods are overloaded methods or not? Yes, obviously, because both methods having the same name and both methods having different argument types. That's why overloaded, don't keep any doubt at all, these methods are overloaded. Okay, test t is equal to new test, t dot m1 of Durga I'm taking, sir. Durga, by default, what type? String type. That's why what is the answer we are going to get, sir? String version, we will get the chance. String version, we will get. Now, sir, t dot m1 of new string buffer. Sir, I'm creating a string buffer object with the argument Durga. No problem. Sir, you know, it is... Sir, now the next case related to overloading, a bit important, take special care. Of course, this case is not required for a verification, but anyway, aware, okay? Here, see this one, public void m1 of int I. Are you getting public void m1 of int I? This is general method. Regarding this one is what? General method, right? Public void M1 of inter dot 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 I. What is this method? Where are the methods are? A new concept which came in which version? 1.5 version. Are you getting in which version 1.5? Sir, very simple. Very simple, sir. If I'm taking a method of int I, like this, I have one method is there. How you can call this method? You can call this method by passing, sir, only one argument. Are you getting? We can call this method by passing only one int value. Okay, well. Suppose if I can take like dot 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 I, sir, mn of int dot 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 I, do you know we can call this method by passing any number of int values including zero number. Are you getting? Suppose you can call without any argument, you can call one int value, you can call two int values, you can call this method by passing 1 lakh int values also, no problem at all. So this type of thing is nothing but what? Where arg method. This is the new concept which came in the 1.5 version. Okay, that's all. This basic idea is enough. Now come back here. Can I use the word? Both the methods are different or not? Same name but different argument types, sir. That's why. Can I use the word overloaded or not? Yes. M1 of int dot dot dot, both are overloaded methods. Sir, now first one general method, where are the method, right? Now test t is equal to new test I'm taking. T dot m1 without any argument. Sir, observe very carefully, sir. T dot m1 without any argument, can you please confirm which method will get the chance? T dot m1 without any argument, can you please confirm? Either first method will get the chance? No. The reason for that is, here have you observed, it is always expected one int value. Is the second method will get the chance? Yes, man. Because it can expect any number of int values including zero number also. You are not passing anything. That's why which method will get the chances, where are the method? Are you getting? Which method will get the chance, where are the method? Because first method is not getting the chance. Similarly, t dot m1 of 10 comma 20. T dot m1 of 10 comma 20. Sir, 10 comma 20, which method? First method? No. Because first method can take one int value, but you are passing two int values. Second method, yes, because second method can take any number of int values. So that's why, sir, here in this case, where are the method only will get the chance. Up to this, any doubt? Because first one not matched, if the first one not matched, sir, the second one matched, that's why matched method will get the chance. Now observe that carefully, sir. Here I'm taking, observe a bit carefully, sir. This is the general method. Public void M1 of int I, general method. This is public void M1 of int dot 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 I, where are the method, right? Now, T dot M1 without any argument, T dot M1 of 10 comma 20. Sir, do you know, in both cases, sir, first method not matched, only second method matched. That's why in both cases only second method will get the chance. Observe carefully. We are not going to get any error. Happily the code compiles fine. What is the answer we will get, sir? In both cases, where are the method, like we are getting the chance. Now observe very carefully, sir. A bit dangerous, sir. Now I'm taking t dot m1 of 10. T dot m1 of 10. 10. Can you please confirm which method will get the chance? One int value. For one int value, general method matched, where are the method also matched? Are you getting? One int value, general method matched, where are the method also matched. Can you please tell who is going to get in the chance? Yes, please make sure. Suppose assume there are two members are there, sir. general method, immediately it's going to tell, observe carefully the scenario. General method matched. Even where-arc method also matched. Sir, both the general method and the where-arc method meet at some common place to fight. Because both methods got chance, they have to fight. So almost 1 hour, they are going to fight. At last, who is going to win the race? Can you please tell? Who is going to win the race? General method will get the chance. Because the reason for that is, general method concept came from 1.0 version, but where-arc method concept came in the middle, new concept, right? Whenever old concept and new concept fighting is there, always old concept is always going to win the race in Java. Remember this general method concept from 1.0 version of Java, it is there. But this bloody where-arc method concept came in which version? 1.5 version. Whenever, if there is any fighting between old concept and a new concept, please make sure old concept is always going to win the race. In Java, old is gold. Remember this. Are you getting right? So which concept is always going to get in the chance? Old. Old concept means general method. So now, what is the answer we are going to get, sir, for this general method only? Now, have a look once. Observe carefully, right? T dot M1 of 10, sir. Are you getting T dot M1 of 10? 10, only one int value. Sir, sir, first method matched because it is expecting only one int value. Even second method also matched because it is expecting any number of int values, including one int value also. So that's why it is also matched. But always, sir, general method will get the chance because it is the old concept. That's why, right? Let me compile, observe the last output, what we are going to get, sir. Yes, general method will get the chance. Everyone can able to understand? Sir, I'm repeating, even in the next classes also, this point is very important, sir. Whenever fighting is there between old concept and new concept, always old concept is always going to win the race. Clear, right? Next point I have to talk about, this where-arc method, right? So where-arc method is always good person, man. Is always good person. How you can conclude it the good person is because of its behavior. Where arc method will always get the least priority. Remember this one, where arc method is always going to get least priority. If no other method matched, then only where arc method will get the chance. So remember this one, if no other method matched, then only where arc method will get the chance. Where arc method will always get the least priority. Remember this one. This is something like in our switch statement. In the switch of X, switch statement. Do you know case 1, case 2, dot, default. Regarding case 1, case 2, dot, default is there. When default case will get the chance? When the default case will get the chance? If no other case matched, then only default is going to get in the chance. Same way, when where arc method will get the chance, if no other method matched, then only where arc method will get the chance. Where arc method will always get the least priority. Compiler is always going to give the precedence, least precedence to where arc method. Please make sure you people should aware. Clear, right?